Hey, here he is. How you doing? Take a seat, sir. Wonderful.
So, yeah, no, sit right there. That's good.
Yeah.
No, right there is perfect.
You can sit there. That's fine.
We set that up nice for you, Mike.
That's fine.
Mike Buschetti is in studio. I love Mike. I don't think we've ever met Mikey.
I met you with Caroline years ago.
What did I do to you?
Probably with Voss.
With Voss? Okay.
Oh, good old Rich Voss. Oh, yeah. He's a treat.
You like the Voss?
Isn't he?
Yeah.
You're nodding on the radio, Mike.
Pull that mic up a little closer to you. There we go.
Okay, cool. Thank you, guys.
I think you could.
That's so weird.
So what are you up to, man?
Oh, sorry. I'm doing really good. Thank you so much for having me, guys. I'm excited.
No problem. First time on the show.
Yeah.
In a couple of years, right? I was here... We came back in August, I think, of like 2011.
All right. It was
were we here?
Not a memorable appearance.
Were we here or not?
I'm fucking with you. I'm fucking with you. All right.
I'm used to being heckled. Kindergarten, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Since kindergarten?
Probably, yeah. But I'm doing something cool about it. I have a thing I put together called Tubby Man about a fat superhero.
Uh-huh.
Then I'm doing a website about it, like anti-bullying.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Mm. We're kind of for the bullying, though.
Oh, I know. I've been bullied a lot.
Oh, no but way.
What kind of bullying, though, Mike?
Yeah.
Oh, like, I was just, my mom was a single mom, right? My dad left us, like, when I was a kid.
Uh-huh.
And we had, like, five kids in total poverty. Where I'm like,
you're in my seat, Mike. Get this over
here. He sat down there. He's ready to get up and move up. He's like, no, that's fine. We set it up all nice for you. It's Jimmy's seat.
My chair's all warm.
Oh, no. Now we broke the other mic.
Mike, what the hell? What happened? Right? Fix it. It's broken.
I'm sorry. I'm
going to
work over there, too.
That's true. There we go.
I screwed up. Sorry, guys.
There it is. You're all good
now. This is the whole thing now.
Mike.
Oh, cool. I got it. Yeah.
There you go. You got that screwed down. Nice. Oh, boy.
How are we doing?
Mike, you all right?
Good. Yeah, I'm not used to being up this early, really.
No?
It's like 9:30-ish.
I know. I get up about 12, I think.
Yeah?
Why?
Just working late, and then, you know, I go to sleep about 6.
Wow.
That's 6, what?
A.M.
Oh, okay. What? So maybe 6 at night.
Let's go back to the bullying thing.
That's baby bedtime.
Yes.
The last time Jim,
you were bullied in school. What kind of bully?
Oh, yeah. Called fat, got picked on.
Oh, man.
Kids bothered me a lot. And then in junior high, I had it. Then I started fighting back, and I loved every minute of it.
Oh, you started kicking some fucking ass.
Yeah, I loved it. I was like, yeah!
Why, because you got big?
Well, you know, just because, like... I got tired of being picked on, and it built up for like 8 years, and I turned to like Luca Brasi one day. It was awesome.
Yeah? Who was the first guy you hit, finally? What would he do to you?
He kept on taunting me and breaking my balls.
Yeah. Verbally or pushing you?
A little bit, yeah, and I just like had it, and I took him outside and gave him a good bloody nose. I loved every minute
of it. Oh, you punched him in the face?
Yeah, you're like...
Was that the first time you ever hit somebody?
A non-family member, yeah. Me and my brothers like the battle growing up.
So were you like, fuck yeah.
Yeah, it felt good to get, you know, I'm Italian, so it felt good to get a little bloodlust out of
me. Man, right?
Are you strong?
No, not really. I mean, you know, it takes me a while to open a jar of pickles even, you know what I mean? I'm not that strong.
That's a great byline and a singles ad.
Oh, no, wait. I just got you right now. You make guys with extra chromosomes strong.
What's that?
You made guys with extra chromosomes strong. I just got it right now, Charlie. Oh, no. Yeah, but Jim played a trick on me at a wedding.
He did.
We went to a friend's wedding.
Yeah.
He said, hold this dish a minute. I'll be right back, right? I'm like, okay. I figured, you know, he'll be back in a few minutes. I'm standing with the same dish for 45 minutes. He's laughing in the corner over there. It's like, he did a lot of good stuff, though. It was fun. I always had my No, but guys, I thought I would have some hot woman tearing my clothes off by now after doing comedy. Yeah.
It's not happening for you.
Not working out.
No.
Well, you know what? I got high taste. I got champagne taste with women. You know what I mean? I like.
What?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Champagne taste in a malt liquor body.
Yeah. I shoot for the stars, man. I don't care. I'm against you now.
Yeah.
I mean, I have a celebrity crush, actually, Christina Ricci.
Christina Ricci?
Yeah.
Really?
All right.
She's all right.
She's hot.
She's pretty hot.
Have you met her?
No, I'm dying to meet her one
day. Have you fantasized about you guys being a couple?
Yeah, pretty much a lot. You know?
What do you think of?
Just kidnapping her. Gigantic tits and just having her all night. You know? Oh, God.
Do you jerk off to her?
Oh, God, have I? Forever. Yeah. Since she's, well, after.
Since the Adams family?
Oh, no.
Before the Adams family.
Yeah.
That's when he stopped.
I waited until, like, she got in the movie Pumpkin with the retarded guy when she was about 21 or so. Oh.
What is that, when you thought you had a shot?
Yeah. I was like, come on, that fucking idiot's banging that whore. Let me have him, because he can't even write his fucking name with a pencil, that idiot. And he's having her.
Ah, Jesus Christ.
So you crank it to her?
That's funny.
Alyssa Milano. I got high taste.
Oh, man.
You know, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
What do you watch when you jack off with them?
I got a great memory. Like, I used to love my mail lady. She was hot. She was stacked.
Your mail lady? I've been to that. I hear you.
Jimmy. I thought about tackling her a few times, but I didn't want to go to jail, you know?
Yeah. It's always better to fucking just keep raping.
Don't act on the urges.
Yeah.
Some bloody manila envelopes left on the fucking stew.
Exactly.
Wiped off on a fucking circular.
A crushed thing of mace with a big sneaker print in it.
A rolled up penny saver shoved in her ass.
Okay. All her teeth missing. Her face fucked. All of her letters eaten. Like a fucking billy goat.
Oh my god.
So I can't jerk off to celebrities unless it's porn. Like I Scarlett Johansson, I think, is hot, but I could never jerk off to her.
Yeah. That is kind of a weird thing. I've never seen him in this, you know, really.
Yeah.
The chick from Titanic.
Oh, the old lady at the end?
Oh, no. Well, maybe. I haven't been late in a long time.
You think about strangling her with that fucking piece of jewelry?
I want to jerk off to the boat movie. Yeah.
I know who you mean.
Kate Winslet.
Oh, God almighty.
Kate Winslet?
She had some nice big and heavies.
Oh, so you probably think of that scene where he's drawing her on the couch. She's laying down like that. Her tits are out. Oh, God, fucking tits.
Instead of drawing her, how you would have taken that pencil and just shoved it right in her forehead.
Oh, yeah. She'd have pencil shavings all over her neck after that.
Oh, yeah. That's great.
I feel like I'm in a cartoon right now.
Oh, God.
Thank you. I love cartoons. I'm a huge fan of cartoons.
Which ones?
I loved Family Guy years ago, like Woody Woodpecker, Bugs Bunny, all the
Felix
classics.
The Cat.
Yeah, Felix, absolutely.
I couldn't stand fucking Family Guy after a while. Just, you know. Yeah, just like.
Why? What part?
That reminds me of the time. All right.
You're saying they do that a lot?
Oh, my
God.
You think
they do that a lot?
The stupid flashback thing.
Have you seen the guy in line that could do, like, every voice from Family Guy perfectly?
I did see him.
It's unbelievable.
He did a newer video.
Did he?
Yeah, because originally I think he did it in his car while he was just fucking driving. Now it looks like he's in some kind of studio setting.
Wow.
Stewie's my favorite.
It's unbelievable. He's got every fucking voice down perfectly.
All those voices are so. To go from Stewie to Brian is not. Oh, God.
Mm. You do voices?
Or
do you just hear them?
I never heard them. Not recently, but I mean.
you ever outside of a grammar school in a van and heard voices?
They were saying, give me candy bars, buddy.
Do a voice.
Hello, my name is Bernard, because I like English people. They're like kind of, I don't know. I loved Joe Pesci's voice. I love him.
You do a little Pesci. Give us a little Pesci.
Right. Let's hear this.
Yeah. Hey, you motherfucker. Give me that sandwich, you cocksucker. I rushed it, but I love him. It's been a while.
Oh,
I rushed it, but I love him.
No, I do love him, because I'd like to meet him one day, hopefully.
Well, who wouldn't? Yeah. Hope he met him.
All right.
Oh, really? Wow.
Met him on a plane. That was denied.
That's cool. Wow.
Denied a picture.
No, because no one's going to believe me, because I don't have a picture of the day.
No, but that's still a great man. Wow.
He didn't. Denied. He felt like he wasn't ready for a photograph there, Mike.
I'm doing a short film with him.
I think
really that's awesome. Are you going to kill him in a gangster movie?
I think you're lying.
Yeah,
that's been one of my favorite goals, like kill him in a gangster movie, stuff him in a car.
I met him briefly. I played Stax's underwear in Goodfellas.
Stax's underwear. Oh, God.
I met Pesci outside the Comedy Cellar years ago. Kevin James was there.
Yeah.
And him and Pesci had done something together. And I saw Pesci getting into a car. I said, I walked up to Kevin. I'm like, is that Joe Pesci? Could you introduce me? He goes, hey, Joe, it's a friend of mine. And Joe actually got out of the car. We took a picture. It was fucking, he wanted nothing to do with me.
You didn't get a picture.
Oh, I do have a picture with Joe Pesci. He had a cigarette in his mouth.
No, you
he don't. Couldn't look unhappier. It's great.
I don't believe it.
Well, do you look like tough guy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Pesci's a fucking, he's a
cool guy. He does look like a tough guy.
No, he definitely looks like a tough guy.
I don't want to get him angry at me. He'd beat the balls off me, I'm sure.
Well, these days he's getting a little up there.
Yeah.
Be a tough guy. Yeah. What's that fucking movie, Las Vegas?
Lost Vegas.
Lost Vegas.
Oh,
Last
does Vegas. That look awful?
Last Vegas. So, Last Vegas. Yeah. What the fuck? Enough play on words.
Yeah. Another De Niro home
it's
run.
It's another De Niro piece of shit.
Oh, God.
Can we watch the trailer?
Yeah, where's the trailer
please?
For that? Let's watch that
Kevin
together.
Kevin Kline, Morgan Freeman, Michael Douglas.
Well, when Morgan Freeman jumps out the window, but then the big reveal is the window's only a foot off the ground. That's some amazing comedy
hilarious.
Right there.
Like the guy in Boardwalk Empire.
Oh.
I was actually in The Family, his new movie. I played a Hasidic Jewish guy being held up at gunpoint.
Oh, you were in that?
Whose movie?
Family.
De Niro.
Oh, I auditioned for that with Michelle Pfeiffer. Did you get to meet De Niro?
No, I met Luc Besson. I never met De Niro.
Oh, that's cool, man.
Yeah, it was fun.
What, did you have the B team for the that day?
They put me on, we did it in Williamsburg. I was terrified because, you know, I didn't want to see them thinking I'm mocking them. And those guys, no joke, they'll kick your butt, around the corner.
Oh.
And I had the Payas, the curly hair and the beard and stuff.
Yeah.
It was fun. It was a pretty fast day.
Well, you always said that you've never met a Jew you wouldn't like to mock.
No, I love Jewish people. I don't want to, I love everybody. As long as I say idiots.
Except for Jews. I hear you.
No.
Just say it, right?
No.
Fair enough. You can like whoever you want. If you don't like the Jews,
no, I love.
You don't like the Jews?
No, I love people. I just don't like
idiots.
Why
don't you like the Jews? What are they doing?
Why are you saying the Jews are idiots?
No, they're not idiots. They're great people. I love them. They got me a lot of. No, I don't want to.
Yeah, no, they control the banks.
No, I don't want to be pushing shopping carts and Pathmark again. No, no.
Because the Jews control that. You're right. Good point.
No,
wow, you don't like Jews.
No, I love them because
you know they run the business, right?
Oh, man, you're going to get kicked out of the business.
Oh, no. It took me long enough to get in.
Oh, that's true.
I can't leave now. No! It's like, I finally got a bank account after how many years? I mean, it's like.
How many years did it take you to get a bank account?
I didn't have a bank account in years, so I got it. I think I was going to get a toaster oven or something cool or a calendar. They don't give me crap anymore.
No.
A calendar? Who wants a calendar?
No, but at least
you don't have one.
No, it's something to be nice. Like, give me a toaster oven and make me feel at home, but happy. But
calendars are still cool, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you don't have a calendar, you need a calendar.
Banks should provide that.
Figure out what day it is, what you got going on the rest of the week.
Right. I became a regular citizen again since I started working on Artie's show. I love it. It's awesome. I'm so happy to be here as well, guys. Thank you.
No problem. How's Artie doing? He's doing all right?
Good. He's doing great.
Okay. Wish him nothing but the best there, Mikey.
Thank you.
No, him, not you. Okay. Can we watch the trailer of this movie?
Why not?
You want to watch this with us, Mike?
Yeah, I love movies. Definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love movies.
No, I do. I really do.
Really?
All right.
All right.
Mike.
Mike. Mike.
Uh-oh. Hey, it's Billy.
Billy!
How you doing? What's going on?
I got something important here, all right? I'm getting married.
What? To that young lady who's half your age?
Hey, wait a minute. She's almost 32.
I have a hemorrhoid that's almost 32.
Let's set up the plot of the movie in a phone call.
Yeah.
To that woman who's half your age?
It sure looks like... Do they ever get in the same room or play?
This looks like one of those movies.
One of those movies where it's star-studded, yet they're never in the same scene because they did all their parts in different cities.
And they got to meet their friends.
Yeah.
Oh, he's marrying that girl. Fucking idiot, De Niro.
But they do go to Vegas, so maybe they do one day of shooting in Vegas, but the rest of the movie they did separately.
Hey, do you hear about Michael Douglas? It was actually tongue cancer that he had.
Yeah, he doesn't.
Instead of throat cancer.
Was it really?
Yeah, he didn't want to say it because
repercussions of the therapy not working are worse for tongue cancer than it is for throat cancer. Like the doctor said, we don't really want to put it out there because people could speculate if it doesn't work. He goes, we got to hack out part of your jaw and your tongue and like, you know, mm-hmm. and then you end up like Ebert. You know?
Tongue cancer. Wow.
So
he bamboozled everyone.
When you have to play it up by saying that you have throat cancer.
Well, he was a smoker, right? He's a big smoker.
No, he got it from that fucking vagina of eating that fucking wife of his. From his wife's fucking
Mike, eat the pussy or what?
Pussy.
I haven't had you a woman since like, if I had something to eat, I would eat it all day.
Oh yeah.
Are you an ass eater?
When was the last time you had?
You'll eat the ass, right, Mike?
I'll eat anything. It's good. As long as she's hot, who cares? Just good.
You like licking a cunt?
Oh yeah. Keep it quiet. As long as you don't break my balls too much. I don't like to be bothered by a woman too much.
How would you break your balls?
Just like, you know, like going on about stuff and going on and on and on.
Well, that's
you just
a
want
woman.
To eat her cunt and get her out.
Yeah, pretty much.
Make her suck your prick.
That's just suck those tits, get out, honey. I want to watch TV a while.
Yeah, suck your prick, you eat her cunt and fucking throw her out.
Right?
Yeah, pretty much.
Like a man's man, right, Mike?
Yeah, I don't like relating. I got to find a woman that's half my age, I hope.
Oh.
Well, I like the young ones.
Well, then this movie's for you. Okay.
I love that. Oh, God. You guys are
Yeah. When was the last chick you were with there?
I'll put it this way. Let's just say the 20th century had some good times in it, you know?
Really? Oh, has it been that many years since you've got...
I've just been focused on
13
this.
Years? Did you pop her in the shitter?
Mm. No, I just, you know, wow. I just like a good hand job, have her suck my bone and then get out of there.
A hand job, suck my bone and get out of there.
All right.
That's on, is get that, on, that's why I've read that on Christian Mingle.
You should make shirts.
Yeah, I should make shirts.
Just a list. Yeah, number one, hand job. Number two, suck my bone. Number three, get out of here. Yeah.
All right, let's go back to the trailer, guys, for this great movie.
Party in Vegas.
I can't smoke, drink, eat salt, or stay out past 9, but...
All right, I love it.
Oh, boy.
Pop, it's sweltering in here. Maybe I should just stay home.
No, you don't have to do that.
Your only job is to relax.
Here he goes, like Ferris Bueller. Oh, Morgan Freeman's jumping out the window.
Yeah.
See?
Oh, Morgan Freeman.
Pause.
The window was on the ground floor.
I love the fucking grown-up Morgan Freeman has to sneak out to go to Vegas.
Right, yeah.
Enough with old people looking like retarded children. You're fucking 80. Tell the kid you're going to Vegas. Go fuck yourself.
Exactly.
Man, oh, no. Here's De Niro face.
Oh.
Now he's coming to get De Niro, I guess, to go.
Hey, what are you doing besides not taking pictures with fans? Yeah, that's funny.
What the hell are you doing here?
Billy is tying the knot in Vegas.
If you think I'm going to Vegas for that selfish bastard, you're dumber than that hat.
Welcome to Las Vegas.
Relax, it's not like you invented it.
How many times I gotta say I'm sorry?
You can't say it enough.
Sorry, boys,
knock it off.
I'm gonna go find some damn water and take all my damn pills. Then we're gonna get this damn party started.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah. Watch out.
Bachelor party!
You know who's supposed to be staying here this weekend?
50.
P-50?
No.
50.
The people in it?
50 Cent. 50. Curtis Jackson, the rapper.
Oh, yeah, from the Jackson 5.
There are girls in every bar. I want all of you to get in trouble.
Which one of you is Sam Harris?
You guys, the best thing ever happened to me.
Tonight, we're going to party like it's 1959.
Bring out the bottles!
Oh, my God. This is terrible.
I'm getting married. She's your age.
You must be rich.
Yeah, but you should be talking to me. Come on.
Hey, buddy, maybe you had too much to drink, huh?
If I want your opinion, I'll just beat it out of you.
No one calls us names except
for us.
They're lifelong friends.
Wow, I get it.
They're lifelong friends.
Oh, this is so embarrassing.
This is good. They're lifelong friends.
They've had each other's backs for a long time.
We can fight, but you can't tangle with any of us.
Right.
It's like, can't they just do movies that aren't like, hey, they're the old guys doing like things? Just be a guy. Be the guy you are. Make a movie. All these movies make is like, oh, look at the old guys are doing wacky young people stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
Ugh.
Mike, you were going to say something. Terrible. I saw it.
It's like, oh, God, this is up there with Dude, Where's My Car?
It is.
It really is.
I'd say so.
Mike, I feel like crying after seeing this.
Yeah, well, it was emotional.
Feel free.
Mike, you have officially become a regular to our show. Yeah, I can't wait for you to come back. You want to see the rest of the trailer? Get to the end of this thing?
Yes.
Okay.
It's not much left.
We got a couple of unresolved issues.
Bring out the bottles!
Oh.
See, because old guys.
I've been this hungover for 30 years. Everything's spinning.
Oh, no.
They're on a spinning bed.
That was a good reveal.
Oh, it's last.
Yeah, I like that one. That's fun.
Last.
See,
Vegas.
I think it's Hangover with old people.
Right. So that's what it looks
that's
like.
That's what you got to do. You got to take something and then add something to it.
Yeah, right.
Is that you on
Hangover?
Twitter?
Oh, that's oh god. What? But you guys are balls. I love people who have guts because
are you on
Hollywood
Twitter?
Don't. They recycle the same stuff. You know, they don't have any guts. Nobody is an innovator.
That's true.
True. Yeah.
Got to agree with you on that one.
Is that you? That Mike Buschetti on Twitter?
Yeah. That's okay. What picture. I hate that picture.
It's why are you handsome?
Let me see the
not
picture.
Really. It's like it was like a bad wedding type. Picture.
Let me see the picture.
Hold on, I will.
Let's see the picture.
Why don't you put a new one in there then?
Yeah.
I'm too fat now. I got to lose weight.
Oh, man.
No, you're not. You look delightful. I took a really handsome photo of you a minute ago.
What's wrong with the picture, Mike?
Well,
you look all right there.
Oh, no, thank you. Thank
let's
you.
Take a what's wrong with that?
Oh,
I don't know.
That's it.
Looks like you got a little attitude.
Yeah.
It does.
Good. Yeah, I was kind of cranky that day.
Nice depth of field on the picture.
Yeah.
Good.
Exactly.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. I just didn't take a lot of pictures growing up. I hate the camera.
Why not?
I don't know. I was a fat kid with, like, tons of acne. I look like Alfred E. Newman.
That's pretty good right there.
See, you should use that picture.
No, oh God. That really
use that as screen grab that and make that your fucking picture.
That happened, guys. They got me on camera. I didn't realize the cameras were always on. And I couldn't sneeze.
You're in the middle of a sneeze there?
That's what happened to me. No, they caught me on camera. I have no idea the camera's always on over there. I couldn't sneeze.
The big picture's taking photographs.
That's literally the worst photo ever taken of anybody.
Yeah.
What do you do for Artie's show? You're the announcer.
Yeah, I'm his announcer. They put me in you know, different things we do. It's a lot of fun. I announce the people. They give me a long list of names to pronounce. It's funny, though. I have a great time. I'm super blessed, though.
B-O-C-C. How do you spell your name?
Oh, B-O-C-C.
Mm-hmm.
H-E-T-T-I.
Thank you.
I met Jim in the early 90s doing comedy.
What was your first impression? What was your first impression? He was funny? Anything else?
Yeah, he had just won a contest, like from Jersey Bud Light or something. It was awesome.
Oh, my God. Wow. That's so many years ago.
No, he was funny since day one.
Thank you. That picture.
Oh, no.
Let me see.
Wait, should I play this?
Yeah.
It started over.
Wow, that is something.
It's a video of Mike not trying not to sneeze.
It's on YouTube?
It's on the Artie Show, yeah.
This should go viral.
It's just him trying not to sneeze.
Send me that link. I gotta tweet that one, Sam.
How bad did you have to sneeze?
That's hilarious.
I bought two different shoes in one day by mistake. Two different color shoes by
that
mistake.
That is fucking hilarious.
Still going.
Oh, it's still going?
Can't sneeze. What the
fuck? That's all it is.
That's perfect.
Send me that link. I got to tweet that for Mikey. Oh, we're going to blow that video up. That's fucking funny, man.
I came in with two different shoes one day because where I live, I'm always in a rush.
They stole the lights?
No, it's like I was running late for work, grabbed two shoes under the bed, didn't even pay attention. I'm getting on the express bus, coming to the city. I look down and I'm like, damn, this one shoe is brown and one is black. What the hell am I going to do now?
Oh, man.
But they had fun with me over there.
Yeah. <You know? laughs>
I tweeted a photo. I just took a picture of Mike and tweeted. If you don't know what Mike looks like,
yeah.
He's handsome. It's a good, actually a good shot of you. If you could, I just caught Mike in mid.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah, I took a good picture.
Can we see Tim Norton's Twitter real fast? Sam. Just Tim Norton on Twitter, of course.
Guys, this is so much fun. I'm really excited. Oh, thank you for having me.
No problem. We're having a blast, Mike.
Let me pull up.
Let me see.
Jim Norton.
Oh, no. See how fat I am, Jim? You never knew me that fat, really.
I might put a couple.
I was half that, Jim, at least.
You got it. You gained a couple pounds. It's okay.
But, Mike, you got your two fingers up.
Don't you worry.
Oh. So it looks like you're commenting on the size of your genitals.
Oh, yeah. It's hard to find them. Oh, God. Now I'm so fat.
Are you a two-finger jerk-off guy when you jerk off? How do you jerk off?
I yell a lot, though. Like, grab and just, like, pull it like it's a banana can come out of his, skin. Sorry.
Wait, how do you, is that how you jerk?
I just grab it and I hold on to it like it's the best thing that ever happened to me and just, you know.
Do you want it with your whole fist or two fingers?
What? This whole hand.
Oh, you grabs it.
So, yeah,
you have big penis?
I think I'm average, I guess. If I wouldn't say I'm large, you know, like average, I would say for a fact.
About five?
A little more, maybe an inch more.
Six.
I don't know what's average today. Who knows?
Your big girthy head?
Oh, I got a gigantic nutsack, though, which is good. Chicks like big balls, I think.
I think. I'm speculating here.
It's been a while, so.
But,
you had a big bag?
No.
Yeah, I love that. That's the best part of it. The bag is where the joy juice comes from, you know?
Do you juggle it while you're jerking?
I love screaming stuff when I'm done during it too.
Like, what?
You're like, what? What do you scream?
What would you scream?
Like Michael Richards of the Laugh Factory.
I'd be like, come on, you whore. Suck this thing like there's no tomorrow. You know, I like stuff.
Oh,
like that,
sexy
really.
Stuff.
Yeah. Like, I actually like tough.
Keep it nice.
Tough chicks that are cool.
Oh, really?
Like leather Tuscadero type chicks?
Oh,
yeah.
Should we get you a chick?
Joan Jett?
Joan Jett was, Joan was hot back in, oh, God almighty.
You're like a little Joan Jett?
Pat Benatar, I was a huge fan of her.
Yeah.
I'd love to have a hot, I just need a hot whore, really. I don't really want a girlfriend.
Look at that. Who's that? Leather Tuscadero?
Leather Tuscadero.
Look out.
So you say suck it like there's no tomorrow?
Yeah.
Yeah.
While
you're jerking off?
Just text me when you need me. I like friends with benefits.
Does she cry because she's upset because there's no tomorrow? That would be very upsetting.
Yeah.
It's like no tomorrow.
Yes. I'll suck it like there's no tomorrow.
I understand a cheap plug for my Twitter, but I just I tweeted that video of you trying to sneeze from Marty Lang's show.
Thank
it's fucking
so
hilarious. Blow that shit up for Mikey.
Thank you.
And follow him on Twitter. I put your Twitter on there too. So
thank you so much.
Holy fuck.
What are you promoting, Mike?
Oh yeah.
My pal Mike Bischetti.
Actually, Jim, I'm on a I was telling Opie I created a web series called Tubby Man about a fat superhero. Okay. You can go to www.savemetubbyman.com.
Oh.
I'm gonna actually be doing a casino down in November 7th and 8th in
I'll help you out. Deuces Wild, is that
yeah.
Oh no, you're doing two though. On November 7th, Mike Bischetti is going to be at Deuces Wild Comedy Club in Valley Forge Casino, and then on the 8th of November in the Waterford Room at the Valley Forge Casino.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
Okay, so they got a couple different rooms.
And also the 19th, coming up October 19th at 9 o'clock, you're in Staten Island at the Looney Bin with Angel Salazar.
It's
going to be fun, and I think Chips is there.
Chips Cooney.
What's that?
Yeah, I love him.
Open the fucking door, Tony.
Come on, Tony. Ernie, you got a job, man.
Guys, I feel comfortable. Dag, I was nervous when I was coming.
Oh,
that's the problem. It's all good.
No, I don't know.
Just hang out. We watch stupid film trailers, goof around
nervous?
A little.
You get nervous.
That's the kind of guy I am, really, but I had a great time, though.
You're a nervous type.
Yeah.
Are you? What makes you nervous?
I don't know. You know, it's just that's how I am. You know, it's hard to explain, but.
Dungan nervous. Yeah. Did you play football?
I played baseball, actually. I did better. I was a good hitter, but a horrible fielder.
Yeah, huh?
They keep me way, 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 way out of the outfield. You know, it's like.
What, would it come at you and you'd just be like, oh, my God, I'm fucking 15 steps too far behind this? Or
No.
Jimmy would spin around in the outfield.
Yeah. A decent hitter, but,
like a little fucking Fairy tard.
You would make a horrible third base coach.
Oh, God,
you'd be
yeah.
waving every single player over.
No, they would crucify me at the plate when I get over there, believe me.
Can you sit still? You think?
Yeah. I'll sit back. That's how I'm at work over there. I'm like,
no, I'm just asking. You don't have to.
No,
say you can't do it.
Oh yeah, he wasn't saying, "Can you sit still?" He was
I'm not.
Not that you should, but let's try to sit still. Not say it. Like just try
for
to
30
talk.
Seconds. I want to see if you can sit still. Yeah. Sit still. Starting right now.
But you got to answer questions too.
Okay, I'm close to the mic. I'm good.
Hands just moved.
Yeah. Your hands
so will you play the league? What position?
I was way in the outfield.
Do you want to fuck Christina Ricci?
Heavily, she's hot. Those tits are huge. That forehead.
He was rumbling a little. His shoulder started moving. You know
what, all right, let's try this again.
It is hilarious.
We got our first bit with Mike Bichette.
Oh my God, he can't stay still.
All right, stay still.
Can I stay like this?
No. Starting right.
Down, there
no
you go.
Shrugging.
Right now, go.
So when you jerk off to Christina, not Christina, what's her name? Christina Ricci?
Oh, yeah.
And you
yeah,
really want to suck her big tits?
Those things are gigantic. Just, oh, fuck.
I think she got a breast reduction, though, didn't she?
I know. That sucks. Why did she listen to people?
I think she decided.
Bob Moravian was on her ass. Get those tits shrunken, you know what I mean?
No, I think she had, like, back problems and stuff. Is that her right there?
Ooh. Oh, no. What happened to her? She got fucking thumbtack tits now.
Wow.
Those are nice.
That looks pretty fucking nice.
Yeah. Oh, God almighty.
Right there.
Hers, right?
Where is she? What movie is she naked in like that?
Your big balls hanging on the floor.
Oh, no.
Your fucking huge bag. Yeah.
That isn't her.
Oh, yeah, it is. You can tell from the face.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Wow, she has shown her tits in a lot of movies.
Those foreheads, you got to reckon. I like the second one. She's so cute. Oh, man.
Yeah, you like that one right there?
Her forehead's a little big.
She has a big round head, and her forehead is giant.
That's okay.
Bangs do her well.
Yeah, would you bang her?
I'd like to shoot that load off that forehead and drip it off.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm sure she'd appreciate that.
That'd be a lot of load.
Nothing a girl loves more than the cum of a psychopath dripping on her forehead.
To first acknowledge the birth defect with some cum.
Oh,
that's where you want to put your cum,
Right.
Her most sensitive, humiliating spot.
Yeah, but I could be a gentleman, too. I like
how about you start with a candlelight dinner or something, Mike? Jesus.
No, you're right, because, like,
right
be
to
nice,
the jizz to the forehead, my
be
God.
Be a gentleman, you know, you're right. That's the whole thing. But guys, everybody I know, all the people I'm friends with, like, women want to be treated like dog shit. That's how you get
them. Uh-huh.
I don't know how true that is. I always...
Oh,
it's nice
true.
Guy, really.
You just fucking pick them up, throw them in a plastic bag, and dump them in the garbage. Like dog shit.
I was always a nice guy. Maybe that's the problem.
Yeah
you sound like found it. Something jerk for off, you yell whore.
Is that Christina Ricci
that's Christina
right
Ricci.
There? Wow, what movie is this?
Black Snake Moan.
Oh, that stupid fucking Samuel Jackson.
I'm disappointed
movie.
In her now.
She's fucking now.
And, oh, God. I'm disappointed in my.
How come? You don't like seeing her with Justin Timberlake?
I bet she's a good fuck.
I'll bet she is.
She's a psych. She plays all psychos in movies. She has to.
Yeah. You fuck her?
Yeah. Yeah.
Would you let her suck your balls?
That's say like, suck that ball.
If you were Christina Ricci's boyfriend and she did this role, you'd be like, she's fucking him.
Yeah.
I'd be freaked out. I'd be
would
so
you?
Bummed out. Yeah,
would
I'd
you be
like,
bummed out?
I'd be like,
what's Justin Timberlake got that you. Oh.
I don't want to fucking see you again, you whore, after that.
Wow,
I'd
that really looks good right
like,
there. Look
you'd be
at
mad
her.
At that, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very
you want her to be all yours.
Girl, I like that. Oh, blow that up.
Whoa.
Now go over. What's she got? Tat tits
she has
just
great
for the movie.
Tits.
Yes, for the for the movie.
Wow,
she does. She looks
nice pussy.
Look
how much better with the bags there, Mike.
Jimmy,
she's
look.
Like 33 now. I know exactly. I think she's born 1980. I don't remember exactly.
Boy, that's a little much. I like that. Yeah, the finger goes up. He goes.
Love it.
Can we see the sneeze?
I love the sneeze video. Did you post that yet? It's very funny.
That one's a
must see.
Do you like that, Sam?
God, it's so great. It's hilarious. Why didn't you just sneeze? Fuck it.
No, you don't have to.
You look like
I didn't even know
Muppet.
I was on camera, really.
That looks like a Muppet.
On all the time.
Why are you holding back a sneeze? That
I
could be the
sneeze.
Worst thing to try to do.
No, I think he wanted to sneeze, but couldn't, so he's up looking at the lights. He's trying.
Anthony, that's it. I couldn't sneeze.
Yeah. He's trying to sneeze.
It's like he's searching in his brain for the sneeze. Yeah. Like his sneeze is all the way up at the top of his head.
Oh, fuck.
Like, we've all been there.
Wow. I got to
I didn't know it was on camera though, until they played it on the show.
What happened? What happened, Jimmy?
I got to retweet Obi the video. That's fucking great.
Oh, it's hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, great.
It's really funny, Mike. We're going to pull that video up, make you a big well, you're a star already.
No.
Who are we kidding?
Thank you, guys.
Now, Otto and George tweeted me and said, did I see Drop in Science? You made a few great appearances on the Pig Roast.
Yeah, it was fun. Wow. Yeah.
I used to like that.
I know, it was fun.
It was very funny.
I loved it.
I loved when Otto went out to the back, to the little patio area.
Yeah.
And just had a little chat and out
just
there.
Just hung out and talked.
And went through the newspaper with George.
Yes, very funny.
That's fucking great.
Just got to bring that back.
What'd you do on that thing?
I actually had a meltdown one day with a listener actually called in and heckled me. And I didn't know it was at the end of the show, and I blew my top, and I didn't realize I was being taped.
who's your top?
Wait, where is that?
My bottom does. You blow the top.
I think it's definitely online because some woman called in. I like California a lot. I want to move out there one day eventually. Oh. I love L.A., right? And she's like, you're a delusion. She was like breaking my chops. I go, honey, you don't even know me. Don't call me delusional.
Oh, shit.
Oh, we got to find this.
It started, and then I just, after the show was over, I said, I called her a cunt.
Oh, man.
Oh, wow. No, not on the air, though, but after the show was done, they got me on tape.
You should say, hey. Rocker. Don't call me delusional, or I'll stop being your boyfriend.
Oh, I want to see you yelling at somebody now.
I never blow my top. It takes a long time for me to get angry, really.
Yeah.
She upset you, though.
Yeah, just, you know what it is? Sometimes, I don't know.
Bitch is going to be bitches, yo. I hear you.
That's why, really, you know, with Twitter, I used to fight back with people and it heckled me, but now we just block them. It ain't even worth it.
That's what you do. Just block them all. Right?
Listen to them.
No, they're morons. They're like,
my goal is to block every single follower I have at some point. That's my final. That's how you win at Twitter.
And then you finally turn off.
You finally turn off Twitter. I blocked everyone that follows me. Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right, Mike.
Mike, great great time. Wow.
Absolutely. Thank you, guys. You
fucking got, pisser.
Thank you for having me. This is so much fun.
No, we'll have you back if you'll come back.
Hell's
no,
yeah.
I'd love to come back. I appreciate this.
We never stay after a school like this.
All right, it's Mike Buscetti on Twitter. I'm going to spell out Buscetti. B-O-C-C-H-E-T-T-I. Mike Buscetti.
On Twitter.
Of course, he announces for the Artie Lang Show. Which is on every night, pretty much, right?
We're on 10 p.m. to 1 a.m. DirecTV, Monday to Friday. And I know we're on Sirius, but I'm not sure what terrestrial we're on as well. I'm not really sure about radio, about that part of it.
So tune in on Sirius XM.
Yeah. Where though?
What channel? I don't know.
Channel?
I'm not really sure. I should know this.
You probably should.
People will find you in the
movie. Getting held up.
Oh, is that
it? Yeah, that's me.
Oh my God.
For the day. It was awesome.
Oh, that's nice.
I wish I had that beard, though.
It's funny to see you mocking Jews like that.
No, I'm not mocking them. They're my people. My cousins are half Italian, half Jewish.
Mocking them.
All right. 243.
Okay.
243.
Extreme Talk
on Sirius XM.
Oh, right. Thank you, buddy. Now I know myself. Very cool. I'm not sure. They're going to hang me at work. They're like, well, that's fat idiot.
And I guess just go to MikeBuscetti.com for all the tour dates, right?
Thank you.
Yeah.
And Mike, it was a pleasure.
It was so much fun, guys. I'm really excited.
Oh, man, no problem. What a pisser.
I love Jim. I know Jim 20 years, at least.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, man. Maybe. More than that.
God, that long, huh?
Yeah, since 1991.
Damn.
Yeah, he was always a funny guy from day one.
What happened?
Wait a minute. I just think the big...
And a cool guy to me, because when I was a new comic, a lot of people broke my balls, because my comedy's kind of different.
Those big balls?
Jim was always a friend of me, though. He always was.
Heavy, heavy, weighty balls.
They broke those big fucking... That big, delicious sack. That big fucking cum-spewing, angry sack. That giant cum factory you call a ball sack.
But you said your comedy's different. Why? In what way?
I'm not a traditional guy talking about... You know, mayonnaise and bullshit and ketchup and being friendly for TV and, you know, all that stuff.
Mustard.
Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. Like, I talk about my dad being, you know, an alcoholic and a drug addict and all kinds of stuff.
What?
And,
that's hilarious.
But the,
no, I know the jokes.
The networks are afraid of originality, though. That's what it is. That's why I love you guys and all people are different because everybody's terrified of originality.
Yeah.
How bad was the alcoholism?
I drank forever from like age 14 to like my late 30s.
No, I was
36.
I was talking about your dad.
Oh, my dad. Oh, he was brutal. He was an animal when he got drunk.
Oh, boy. Not fun, huh?
No. My mom's the best. She's a single mom and she raised five of us.
He hit you, your father?
Now he wouldn't be able to. He's old, but, you know.
Oh. But back then, I mean.
No, not really. He'd do a lot of yelling and throwing stuff.
Okay.
You like him?
Bad. He's a reasonable guy.
This humongous is a reasonable man.
He's a reasonable guy.
I'll talk to this humongous.
You see him still?
Actually, he's pretty sick right now. He's in a nursing home. I got to go visit him, actually.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you know, what are you going to do?
What's wrong with him?
He has a problem. He couldn't breathe. And they had to do an operation problem. On him, like a tracheotomy, whatever it is.
Tracheotomy.
Yeah. Yeah, it's okay. I mean, you know, things happen.
How old a gentleman is he?
75.
Okay.
How old are you?
I'm the beautiful age of 52, unfortunately.
Wow. There you go.
Okay.
I had to put you younger than that.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. That,
you don't have
you got
to,
the
really.
Finger thing.
I know. I got the two fingers.
Nice.
Double fingers.
Double fingers.
No, I... I just love doing what I do. I mean, this is so cool because, I mean, it took me a long time to get where I did, but it's worth every minute of this.
Yeah. What happened? Roland. Roland's sitting back there. What's up, Rolly?
That movie made me want to cry, though. I can't stop thinking of what Michael Douglas.
The Woodsman?
Man.
The Woodsman. The Woodsman.
Whoa. Well, I've never seen him before. I'm not up this early normally.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm just an exhibit with you guys.
What movie made you want to cry?
De Niro's. I'm like, fuck, what happened to him?
Oh, in a bad way, yeah.
And Michael Douglas oh, God.
Well, Michael Douglas looked great in there. You know, he's all tan. Nice full head of hair.
That's a formula movie, and he'll do well. Whatever.
But he's just doing nothing but garbage for years.
They should have fucking did something else. Those guys. Shit.
Nobody has any balls to do anything. They're afraid of their own shadow.
Yeah. De Niro just gave up on, people just don't give him good scripts anymore. I can't imagine that.
Even Silver Lining Playbook got rewarded because it was the first thing he did in years that was different than a dumb comedy. That was awful.
Like, it's got to be easier to just do these shit movies than it's like, oh, my God, I got to really act. And
right. I got to be the guy for a while, get into the character.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's because of Meet the Parents. He was really... He killed it in Meet the Parents, especially the first movie. So now it's like, okay, that's what I got to do now. A million of these type of movies.
That sucks.
Too bad.
Yeah. I want to tell...
I wasn't impressed with him in Silver Lining Playbook.
Me neither, bro. No.
I thought he was all right. Exactly. But it wasn't an over-the-top performance by any means.
That was a bunch of bunk, if you ask me.
Bring it back to Cape Fear, things like that.
Oh,
awesome.
God, Cape Fear.
Sure, and you relate to the way he talks to a girl, right?
Oh, yeah.
That's how you have sex.
I hear you do the laugh from Cape Fear.
I actually like the movie Full Metal Jacket. That's one of my favorites. I'll just like...
Oh, you do any impressions from that movie?
Pile on the Toilet.
I like when he goes, Pile, Joker, Snowball! That's my favorite when he's calling him out. And Pile, I felt sorry for him in the long run. I mean, he was...
Oh.
Yeah. But it was a good movie, though. I like Ollie Army, though. I'd love to meet him one day.
We met him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He yelled at us, too.
Really?
Yeah, for real.
He's a badass, though. I'm sure he can fight, still, right? You think...
No, not really.
Oh, nowadays, it's crazy.
You didn't hear what happened to him, which makes it really awkward now.
No. Oh, no.
Don't bring it up.
I would like to tell you about...
What happened, Aunt?
Netflix new comedy special, Notorious.
Yeah, a lot of the language isn't very salty.
Well, it's got Russell Peters. You know Russell Peters, he's great. He's one of the biggest comedians in the whole wide world. Well, now, along with Orange is the New Black, House of Cards, and Arrested Development, you got Notorious. That's his newest special. Russell Peters. And This guy's huge, right? Over 75 million views on YouTube. Well, a million Facebook fans.
That's mind-blowing.
That is mind-blowing, isn't it? And one of the most diverse audiences on the planet, apparently. Multicultural, I guess. Oh, boy, he sold out Madison Square Garden, Sydney's Royal Opera House. And also launching with Russell's new special, Notorious. It's Russell Peters versus the world.
I can't even sell out Beefsteak Charlie's.
Where... When was the last time you saw a Beefsteak Charlie's?
Well, something to that, you know, effect. I mean, like bad bingo halls, like in the middle of nowhere.
I love the reference. I haven't seen a Beefsteak Charlie's in 20 fucking years.
You're quickly becoming my favorite person in the world.
I love him. Oh, God. Yeah, along with Russell's new special, Notorious, Russell Peters versus the World is an exclusive four-part series that takes you behind the scenes of Russell's tour. Tons of great outtakes and interviews with his friends and family.
Is he dirty like Sam Kennison?
I don't know. Is Russell Peters very dirty? I don't think so.
No, not necessarily. No.
Big audience. Yeah. You know, he's one of these very marketable comedians.
Disney friendly, like you know, like... balloon animal jokes, things like that. Like,
well, I think it's more than that if you're going to get 75 million viewers on
YouTube.
That's
awesome, though.
Well, yeah. So don't miss, you know, Notorious. And, of course, Russell Peters versus the world.
He'll probably kick my butt if he'll hunt me. Well, he don't have time to hunt me down. He's selling out stadiums.
Yeah, that's true. He's selling out Madison Square Garden. And
he don't have time to worry about some fat guy someplace.
Well, no, he wouldn't. He wouldn't. And, of course, Russell Peters versus the world is special.
He'll send me somebody. He'll send somebody to kick my ass. He's got that kind of money now.
He's got kick people's ass money.
He can just go punch that fat guy out.
Right.
He'll eat popcorn while I get my ass kicked.
I hear you. And that's
I'm in, by the way, the second episode of this.
Oh, you are? Oh,
yes, because I interviewed Russell for Town Hall. Nice.
Oh, I'll see that then.
Yeah.
And that, of course, is streaming, and it's only.
How old is he about?
I'm not even sure.
Is he like, he's not my age. He's probably,
I think he's younger.
He's like 40, 43.
Yeah.
God bless him. That's amazing. It's like 75 million. Whoa, God almighty. It's
Yeah. That's Russell Peters, Notorious, and Russell Peters versus the world, now streaming only.
Can you give me some whores? I think I want to be friends with him. That I mean, 75 million people. You got to have an army of skanks, I'm sure.
We got one more read.
Only on gotta be
Netflix.
On
Netflix.
Mike, can you do our last live read, please?
We do not feel like doing it.
Yeah, I'd really appreciate it.
If you ask any girl, any woman, what the best you can ever got was without situation. Oh, no, that fucking idiot. I'm sorry. Without even thinking about it. She may say her engagement ring is so important. It's just not a ring. It's just a sign of affection. It's everything to her. Oh, I'm sorry. I'll start again. I'm sorry. If you ask any girl, any woman, what the best gift she ever got was, without hesitation, without even thinking about it, she'll say her engagement ring. Okay, honey, don't lie to me. It's so important because it's not just the ring, not just a sign of affection. It's everything to her.
Hey, Mike. Huh? The client wants us to improvise these. So when...
Oh, okay.
Sure. Improvise a little bit. Read it.
Like,
and
like a one-liner. Really like,
I mean, that's just like a script to follow, which, we, you know, but then when you're feeling some improv, just throw it in there for us. The client really appreciates that. And, and honestly, it doesn't matter what you say. So don't hold back.
If you ask any
girl...
Be
Mike Bichette.
Oh, thank you, guys. If you ask any girl, anyone, the best thing she got was a piece of my balls. She was without hesitation. She sucked that banana all fucking night, that filthy skank. She said it was an engagement ring. Yeah, you fucking lying whore. That engagement ring wasn't even the purchase of the prices. That fucking ring, you fucking skankosaurus. It's not just a ring. It's a sign of affection. Yeah, you lying whore, because... Everything to her. Yeah, okay. She looks down at her finger every time she washes her hands. Yeah, she don't wash her hands, that filthy pig. She got fucking scurvy on her hands, that whore. Every time someone at the store hands her change, that's because she's sucking dick for fucking milk money. Her credit. Every time she shows her friend, her friends are fucking animals like her. They're pigs. They're fucking handed out hand jobs for fucking $8 and a fucking bologna sandwich on fucking Third Avenue someplace in Manhattan. For that ring, that whore will fucking chew her own dad's dick off, actually. But what do you call it? She's so perfect. Yeah, she's perfect. Listen, whore, shut the fuck up and bite the bone. What do you call it? Yes, Steven Singer. Who the fuck is this jeweler? He's a fucking idiot. He's been pushing since fucking the third grade, that idiot. What do you call it? And it's painless. Yeah, all right. So many of our guys have made it to the trip. What? This guy's a fucking nincompoop. He hasn't fucking. He is. I mean, 100% money back guarantee. You got to give me my money back because that whore ain't worth a fucking pack of cigarettes, really. Because you get the best service, the best. Yeah, okay. Look, you can do it. Listen, I'm sick of that whore. I'm not even going to call that skank. I'll put her on my, you know, fucking whore list and, you know, just, you know, a booty call that whore and just text me when you want a fucking dick in your mouth, skank. What do you call it? Because I just love whores.
Steven Singer Jewelers.
That's the other corner of 8th and Waldo.
Right, of course.
Do you have the phone number there, Mike, for the people?
Oh,
just read the bottom
part. You actually
have
to give the real
okay,
number.
Okay, 1-888-HATE-STEVEN-SINGER, align it, IHateStevenSinger.com.
Very good.
That was actually great.
That was it.
Yeah.
Oh. Sorry, I got a
what?
What?
No, it was fun.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. I
we
really
lost,
do love
we might have lost a client, but fuck it. It's all right.
Yeah, the language is a little rough.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We didn't expect you to go that rough with that. You know?
I'm sorry. Oh. I just got a brutal,
keep
filthy
between the lines,
mouth.
I mean, but, you know, whatever.
Oh, God.
It's all right.
Jim's my mentor, really. I mean, he was always a good guy to me when we started comedy. He never took any shit from people. I love him for that reason.
He's taking shit from certain girls.
Women will do that to everybody, no matter who you are, really. I mean,
that's
they can eat you up like a
I meant on
alive.
His chest and face.
You guys have known each other a while? Or?
Since like 91.
Wow.
Yeah. It's a long time.
He actually did. I'm a big fan of Dice. He did me one of the first time, before I met him, I met him in California back in 95. He met me downtown one night. He goes, I got a gift for you. He bought me a headshot of Dice.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, it was signed, right?
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Somebody, I wish you would have brought you the head of Dice.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, God. I'm,
why?
Why are you, what?
Somebody wants to meet Mike before we go.
Who?
DJ Who Kid.
DJ Who
Kid. Oh, DJ Who Kid.
He doesn't know Mike, and so he's just texting asking if we were here. I just thought.
Yeah, let's bring in DJ
We should just have Who Kid pop in real quick.
Where is he?
He's a colored gentleman.
Who Kid.
Oh, cool.
Okay
with that?
You like
coming
the color?
The hall.
Yeah. People are cool. I just love everybody. It's awesome.
He's a DJ here.
What is that?
Oh, Oliver Stone's Untold History of the United States, 12 chapters on 4 discs.
Wow, you know that's going to be good. Yo, who?
Wait, what? Jimmy has one?
Pop on Mike 8.
What?
They'll send me one.
DJ Who Kid in the house. With a Morrison t-shirt now.
Kid. What up, yo?
And with the special number 27. I see what's going on there.
Motherfuckers is dying, yo.
At the 27.
You don't know Mike?
No, this is my first
buddy,
time.
Nice to meet
what
you.
Up, son?
How are you?
Okay.
He's scared of colored people.
No, I'm not scared of it.
We figured we'd have you come in. Yeah, he's scared of the colored.
No, I'm not scared of people. I just don't like idiots.
Look at him. You tell me if he's scared or not. All right?
What happened? He's scared of black people?
Yeah,
no, I'm not scared of I'm not a friend.
How come you don't like black people? That's weird.
Oh, what are you doing to me? Oh.
Seriously?
No, I get along with everybody. I just don't like jerk-offs in life.
Oh, you call them black people jerk-offs.
No.
Oh,
that's what he said a minute ago.
No, I didn't. Yeah.
See, you tell me if he's nervous or not.
He looks kind of nervous.
All right, so, you know. He's trying to be cool.
Thank you, but I try to be cool, but I'm not really.
They don't have niggas that hang around you, like in your neighborhood?
Where I live now, it's like where I live on Staten Island, it's like the witness protection program on our block. It's kind of like, you know, like.
But no, you know.
He's really nervous.
Right,
now.
No Mondays.
Yeah. It's all right to be nervous.
No, I'm not nervous. I mean,
I'm black.
Know.
I understand. You know,
no Canadians.
This shit.
Oh, that's a code word for a bad thing, man. I know no Canadians. God. Damn!
If Jim Norton is not afraid of black people, you shouldn't be.
I'm never him. I like people for people.
Look at the horse. Damn.
Who Kid hangs out with?
Yeah, I have white
looking
bitches.
Fucking look at that.
Can you bring me some?
I can get some white bitches. But
yeah. Wow. Ooh.
I'm trying to make you comfortable right now. You see, that's white moisture.
Mike was just talking about.
I like. brunettes are hot.
Now he's not nervous.
No, he's not nervous anymore.
Mike likes his big white ball sucked.
He's got a giant ball bag.
The brunettes hot though. I mean, you got great taste.
It's white bitches. You know,
he likes it when they jump on his bone.
For real?
Yeah.
Just jump in the bone and ride the pony, honey.
How old are you?
52.
You're 52.
But I like women like around 32.
You look a little younger. I like 52.
He looks younger.
That's what I thought too.
And he's packing 6, which is above average. 6 inches.
Is it? I don't know what the standards are today.
Just about.
You talking about his dick?
Yeah.
Oh.
Not for you, for the bitches.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah. He wants some of them bitches.
You're not bisexual, Mike.
Are you bisexual?
No, I like whores. I don't like. I don't suck dick. I don't like no sugar in my tank and that stuff.
Sugar in your tank.
I don't like fucking getting fucked in the ass. I love women. Oh,
we didn't ask all that.
I'm sorry.
You ever have your ass eaten?
Oh no. That ass is just for crapping. Nobody's going near it.
You ever had your ass
sugar?
This ass is made for crapping.
Yeah.
That's just what it'll do.
No sugar in my gas tank. What?
I love my ass, like, dude.
You never had it?
No, they're not going near that thing. My prized possession. Really.
You're 52. You never had a bisexual experience by mistake?
No. I'd like to watch some chicks do each other. And then
you were never in the Boy Scouts or anything like that?
Oh, I was a Boy Scout, yeah.
They just never asked you into the tent.
Well, I also, believe it or not, for a short period of time, I joined Marines when I was young.
How do you join the Marines for a short period of time?
Well, I it was mutual agreement that I left, actually, you know.
You never do that.
Bygones be bygones?
There's never a mutual agreement.
It was like, you know, they were like, well, you know, the minute I get off the bus, all hell broke loose. Right.
Was it after the whole platoon hit you with the soap?
No, it was before that. I get off the bus and all, this was like,
what do you mean all hell broke loose?
A jelly donut!
Break it down. What happened?
You had to run up to like Yellow Footprints, and you would say, "Sir, yes, sir," right? And by mistake, well, first of all, when they got on the bus, the guy looked like all the Army,
sure.
And he goes, "You're now property of the United States government. You're now in the United States Marine Corps. You got 3 seconds to get off this bus." So guys are pushing, fighting to get off. I'm like the last guy off the bus.
Oh,
I figure, let me take my time. I'll get out there when I'm ready to get out there. You know what I mean, right? So I get out there, and they say, when you hear your name, you'll say, sir, yes, sir. So I went, yes, sir. He goes, he looked at me, he goes, who's a dick sucker that got a cock caught down his throat and said, yes, sir, instead of sir, yes, sir.
No.
He goes, was it you, Liberace? And he says to me, I go,
Liberace?
He goes, your name is Milton Bradley from now on, son. There's going to be so many games to play with you. You're never going to want to come back.
Milton Bradley.
Oh, wow.
But when I met my drill instructor, he goes, I will turn into Lee Harvey Oswald by the time it is.
Jesus Christ.
Wow. He had to make you more, like, he had to put you on medication and make you more sane. To make you awesome.
It was great because, like.
So, how long were you in?
I was in for 6 weeks, the first phase of training. Then they decided to, you know.
How'd they break it to you?
The guy said, well, this isn't really working out for us. Well, you really.
Wow. Did he lose weight? Were you.
No, I was in good shape. And
you were in pretty good shape?
When, actually.
But what do you mean they said it didn't work out? Like, what you
they
do?
They said, well, you know, you're not actually right for this. You know what I mean? Because
the Marines did.
They never say that. Even if they just want some cannon fodder.
Were they mean to you or no?
No, they were actually, by mistake one day.
They must have went to the recruiter and just went,
I haven't
fuck
seen,
you
know,
thinking?
We didn't see women for a few weeks because you're down there. And then
I know you were horny as fuck.
Oh, yeah, I seen women. I seen some woman Marines that, like, look like Vulcans from Star Trek. Their hair was short. I didn't give a shit what they looked like. I'm checking them out. And everything you had to say was, sir, yes, sir, right?
Get out of here.
So that woman Marine comes over to me, right?
Cunt.
And I go to her, sir.
Cunt.
I called her sir, right? She goes, do I look like a sir to you? I go, sir. So all of a sudden, my drill instructor stops the platoon, right? He goes, and my nickname was Space Cookie. That's how he called me. He goes, Space Cookie. I knew this had to be you. He goes, what
you
got to
get that on a shirt, who kid?
Space Cookie.
You got to get Space Cookie on a cookie. Shirt.
He goes, he's coming
he
out.
He goes, what did
I'll
he
buy
do
one
now?
Of those.
He said he called me sir instead of ma'am. So he looked at her and said, that mistake is understandable.
Oh,
and he just walked
shit.
Away.
Wow.
But he was on my side for once.
It was probably more fun for him to goof on the bitch than it was you at that point.
Yeah.
Right there.
When I got there, I'm like, I thought this was going to be John Wayne charging over the hill. I'd get chicks, beat up bullies, and pick up when I came back.
Oh,
you know,
man.
It was more
right?
like John Wayne Gacy.
I thought no good hot chicks, like, beat up bullies
hot
and pick up
chicks.
On me. You know, they're like Marines and stuff.
Didn't work out that way for you.
No, it was, oh, God, because when I got there, they were like, he gave us a speech. It's like, he said, my name is Sergeant Rear. I'll do the speech. It was like piling
Please
full
do
no
the
jacket.
Goes, really get into it, too.
He goes, my name is Sergeant Rivers. You will refer to me as sir. For the next 12 weeks, I will be your mom, dad, boyfriend, girlfriend, bisexual, pimping bitch. He goes, my primary objective is to teach you to kill. And I'm like, wait, that last part, my primary objective to teach you to kill. I didn't realize that was a job over there. You know
yeah,
what I mean? I
you thought, kill motherfuckers.
Yeah, I thought, you know, I thought, hey, man, it'll be cool just wearing a uniform, beating up guys and beat up on me. You know what I mean, right? I
didn't what realize did you it was think like, the Marine Corps did? That's I thought like it was what like, they you know, do like, is like kill. Being,
you kill know, like, motherfuckers, man.
I didn't realize it was that intense.
Oh, my God. That intense. The whole history of the Marines are killing people.
I got
people.
Killing machines. Screwing up. That's how I got the name
Choke
Space
yourself.
Cookie.
What'd you do? How'd you get Space Cookie?
My combination lock, you know, to give you a lock, was Uh-oh. Messed up. So oh, it wasn't okay. working right from the second I got
oh,
it.
Oh, no. An unlocked footlocker.
I'm in squad bay trying to open it. I'm still in my underwear. Everybody else is in the squad chow hall eating.
Oh,
he came back from there. And he just came out with the name because they're so good at improv and people and breaking balls. He goes, Space Cookie. He goes, you're ruining my Marine Corps, son.
You're ruining.
He said that. He grabbed my face as red as an apple. He goes, next time I will kill you, bitch.
Wow.
And I'm like, and he meant it. Really, really. He
damn.
Did.
Why wow. was your fucking lock? So you're in your underpants trying to unlock your
I'm
locker.
I'm like fucking with it like this. Everybody else is eating. I'm like, damn this. Why can't I open this? Got fucked with this lock. I hope that he's not fucking looking for me now.
Wow.
Did you get it open?
No, they actually gave me a couple of different punishments over there.
What were some of the
day.
Punishments?
Yeah. One day I was, one day by mistake, I said to a drill instructor, sir, good morning, sir. It was early in the afternoon.
Is that crazy?
Right. I go, sir, good morning. He goes, does it look like a morning to you? He goes, who do you belong to? I go, sir, I'm in the 3rd Battalion spilling my guts. And he goes, I'm going to teach you a lesson from now on. He gave me like a plastic stopwatch he had. He goes, you're going to be the official timekeeper of the 3rd Battalion. I had him walk back and forth. And he goes, and your name's going to be Big Ben, son.
So I had a lot of names.
Right. Yeah.
No, he goes.
Crazy AKA.
Yeah, yeah. He had me in front of the thing. I had to say, my name is Big Ben. I'm the official timekeeper of the 3rd Battalion. I screwed up and told drill instructor Smith it was morning instead of afternoon. But in the meantime, he caught some guy laughing at me.
Uh-oh.
And he said, after I got done with that, this guy had to say, my name is Barabbas. I laughed at him. That's what he made me say, so.
Brer Rabbit?
Barabbas, from the crucifixion. They made him say that.
It was a Brer Rabbit.
No, and then, what do you call it? So I'm standing there walking back and forth, right? Meanwhile, other platoons of drill instructors are coming over to me, and they're like, here's an example of what not to do, you know?
Oh, right? Jesus.
Wow.
You know?
How'd you do as far as, like, marksmanship and stuff?
Good. I had a rifle and shotgun permit until, like, the mid-80s or late-80s. I used to go to range. Unfortunately, I, you know, got rid of all my weapons at home.
Is he considered a vet?
Yeah, are you a vet?
You got shot in the ass or anything like that?
I get some, you know, they tried to, you know, get me vet's insurance to buy a house, but I don't know.
How was your, what kind of discharge did you get?
I got an honorable.
Honorable, after 6 weeks?
And all these memories.
That was awesome, because I learned that, you know, you're not you thought as a unit, not an individual. I learned that pretty
in
fast.
In 6 weeks.
That's crazy.
So what happened to all your weapons? How come you got rid of them?
I just used to go to range a lot. My mom was, because, you know, my mom was like, why do you need this many guns in the house? I'm like, well, you know, I like the target shooting, really.
Yeah.
Not people shooting, you know.
Well, no. Unless the, you know.
Did you have a six-pack when you were in the Army?
I was in good shape. I was about 155 pounds.
155.
What do you
shit.
Know?
Oh, God, I'm an obese piece of fat crap. I'm afraid to go near a scale this way I'm now, because scale spins.
Should we have one? You should know. It's always healthy to know.
Say that again?
We have a scale?
Yeah.
The scale, I don't know if the scale's going to work, because you know why? It usually goes around a couple of times and don't register.
You're like a good 270, 300.
Thank you, buddy. I wish I was. I'm probably three something.
You're over three. No.
Serious?
Yeah. Carried well or something.
You're like a human biscuit.
Huh? I try, guys. This is some.
This is cool. You don't like. You're starting to like black people. I noticed.
I know, man. I love everybody. It's cool.
I mean, you saw me with some white bitches. You got comfortable.
Yeah, he's cool now. Yeah.
You know, black people are cooler than white people. You guys got style and rhythm and stuff.
Why are you on style and rhythm?
Jesus Christ!
Thanks, man.
No, I mean,
what do you mean by that?
That's great.
Good looking, God.
Yeah. What do you mean by that? Because you got that big extra bone.
No, I'm just saying style by like having a uniqueness. You know. Yeah. I mean, not like
and big pricks, right, Mike?
White people are bored. I'm not like the typical.
You're not uncomfortable with that. My big black cock is going in.
White people
bitches.
Are boring with their jobs.
You don't care about that.
No, have fun with them, man.
Staying out of prison.
No, because I'm not your typical L.O. Bean white pilgrim Viking white guy. Really?
You say you don't care about my dick going in white bitches?
No,
it's cool.
Have fun with them, man. That's what women are made for.
All right.
That's what women are made for. That's what women are made for.
Just have fun banging and enjoying stuff.
You never banged a black chick before?
No, I love black
Isn't that a Lionel Richie beautiful. Song?
You say you like
That's what
chicks.
Women are made for.
Yes.
Where you just
you
fuck them.
He's
into black chicks?
No, because actually where I grew up. I grew up in like Donnie Brasco film.
Little Oil Derrick action?
On Staten Island.
Loyal Derrick.
Little Oil Derrick action?
No, I don't... I'm telling you, yeah, I like
dipping
Hispanic
into that
too.
Sweet crude, that light and sweet crude.
I don't care because as long as they don't complain too much, I don't want to be ragged on. I really don't care. You know?
No, huh?
I can't take being ragged on. Really,
I don't mind being ragged on. I'll fuck them any time of the month. Get it? See?
I need you to tell me. I need you to tell me if I'm a stupid N-word. I just found out that Johnny Carson died.
What?
That N-word should be. Should anybody had said it should have the fucking ass beat down.
Uh-oh. Okay, Mike,
I better leave.
You want to jump on? We'll give you
a my ass beat.
I just found out Johnny Carson died.
How did you not know that?
Come on.
Sam.
They didn't tweet it.
You know Don Cornelius? Did you know Don Cornelius died?
Hold on, Mike's getting on right now. Let's do this.
What is he, 320?
Oh, shit. Uh-oh.
You hit it right on the head.
320.
320?
Who kid knew?
You like a human biscuit.
Yeah. He's
like, guys, if I can get down
there's
to
some gravy on this guy. So,
guys, it's night eating. I'm telling you. I'm like a closet night eater. Like,
don't walk in KFC because all the black people will eat you up, man.
What do you eat at night?
Biscuit.
Yeah, what do you like to eat at night?
like ice cream and all kinds of stuff.
Oh, man.
Late. I can't have
You got a sweet
it, you know?
Tooth, yeah. huh?
And pussy. Yeah.
When I can get some up. You guys are great tasting woman, man. We got to hang and get some horse.
Hold on,
matter of fact,
we got a fan on the line.
Can I bring him?
And he reminds me of the guy we're about to take the phone call from.
Oh, cool. Colin.
Hey, Big A.
Oh, it's Big A.
Oh, he's awesome. Well,
he's on the phone. He wants to say hi. Big A.
Hey. What's up, everybody?
All right.
Yeah, I just wanted to call up because I met Mike at the Otto and George.
Yeah, at the pig roast. Big A's awesome. We had so
Would
much
you
fun
two get
him.
Away?
No, but the piglets were hot. Those chicks on the show.
Yeah.
Oh, God almighty.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, we had so much fun together. It was great.
Sounds like it.
I know I'm adding too much to this show. I just want to call him.
Big A rules. Thanks, Big A.
If you mean weight, you are.
All right.
It's adding a lot of weight to the show.
Should I bring him to the club on Sunday? I'm DJing.
Damn.
I'll bring him to the club. We'll fuck some bitches. I'm dead ass serious.
How old? Like, I don't know. I'm going to go too
Jesus,
young.
Jesus, look how picky.
No, I'm just saying.
He wants to go young.
20 and up, I guess, you know.
He wants to go young.
Like, early 30s are good.
Nah, I fuck with 20-year-olds.
He wants like 11, 12.
Don't be so picky, Mike. Only Capricorns.
Somewhere. Something where you could snap their neck real easy afterwards.
What are you going to do at the club with Mike Buschetti? Who, kid?
What was that?
What are you gonna do with Mike Buschetti at the club?
I mean, I'll throw some bitches on him. You gotta do you. You know what I'm saying?
Sit at a table, get some bottles. Yeah,
get him a
up
Versace
in that,
shirt.
Motherfucker.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'll get you a Versace shirt. I'll take you shopping. Because right
That's
now you look
I'm
like
saying.
You're about to go fishing or something. I don't know. Like
I know. It's like somebody gave me a fan gave me a old miss. I don't really know football that well. It's like.
I gotta get you some Versace, but maybe a pair of Nikes. You know, you got the Reeboks.
Would you point him out like to the. Mike can fucking get some girls for him.
Yeah, I'll get him some.
Introduce him around.
Yeah.
That's why I got a Versace shirt, so you look like you got some paper. You know what I'm saying? Some money.
Yeah, you go. Do you have paper?
Some guap.
That's
right. Yeah.
I just finally became a citizen after so many years not doing it. What I mean, I mean, you know, making money wise, I'm talking
about.
You're legit now. It's
like, yeah, it feels good to have a bank account. I'm like, whoa.
Well, that's for sure.
What? He just not getting the bank account?
He's a funny dude, too.
Yeah,
man.
Well, Mike,
he works with Artie Lang.
He takes his time.
Oh, for real? You sold drugs in your own life.
I did whatever I did. I did like all kinds of gigs, whatever it took. You know, it's like I was, like I said earlier,
shit.
I was the king of bingo halls.
Who's coming out of fucking Shade?
Yeah, who's that guy?
Saw a couple of guests leaving.
Got to be a basketball player, right?
I don't know.
The guy with the dress?
He didn't seem that tall.
He has a dress on?
This guy's wearing like a fucking skirt.
There's a new style now. You know what the dresses are in now. Dudes can wear dresses.
Dudes are wearing black dudes can wear
fucking dresses. Who started that?
Kanye did.
Kanye with that dumb leather dress he was wearing.
And now there's a whole,
not us.
Now there's a whole thing going on.
If I can get Andy to wear a dress.
Oh, like
a
man, that ain't going to happen.
Is that really going down?
Yeah.
That ain't going to happen.
My dreams are coming true.
No.
Who's wearing the dresses, who kid?
It's like some shit they took from France, like some Paris shit.
Yeah, first the chains, and now you guys are going back to loincloths.
Jewelry, I don't
know. Motherfuckers.
Oh, gosh.
You keep going back.
Is it like Braveheart dressing?
You think they're Scottish? I don't know. What the fuck is going on?
Oh, God.
Yeah, it's like
Braveheart.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nah, I wouldn't put you in a skirt, but I'll get you a Versace shirt. I'd make you look like Biggie, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah,
shit.
Thank you,
buddy. You know what I'm saying? Notorious.
Big chain?
Ah, fuck.
I won't put jewelry on him. He might get robbed.
Where are you DJing?
Whip. It's on where Drake and what's the name had a fight, and Chris Brown.
So start
fighting there.
I got you back if a fight happens. Believe me,
be prepared. There's a lot of niggas in there. You're gonna be.
I don't care. I'm
letting you know now.
No nigga. Jerk offs though, right?
No.
All right.
Who cares? People are people. I don't care.
You sure? Okay. All right. We're gonna see. I'll put him on Instagram. I'll film him.
Nice.
Make a wiggle. You know what I'm saying?
Wow. Damn. Yeah.
You know how to dance? You know how to dance hip hop?
I can dance.
Well, how about you have him do a little hip hop dance?
What kind of dance can you do?
Yeah. Let's see a dance there,
Mike. Oh God!
I mean, you gotta know, that, watch your watch the scale. Don't like,
okay, you got some for
that stuff, buddy.
Let me do. I'll do the niggas in Paris beat for him with my mouth.
I don't know. I can't
oh, that's all right.
That's not bad.
Whoa, he spins.
Boss so hard, motherfucker, gonna find me.
Doing like a boxing thing.
Yeah.
Like a little boxing move. Yeah.
That was L, right? You saw that?
Jay-Z out on the fucking that. Dance floor. That'll be pretty good.
For a fact, I can move.
Oh, man.
When's the last time you were in a club?
Oh, God. I don't know. It's been a while.
Damn. He's like foaming at the mouth, man.
It's crazy.
No, you're cool, man.
Motherfucker, man. Hang with me, yo. I'll get you some pussy. Get you some bitches. And we just have a good time. Go home, you know what I mean?
You're going to be fucking hooked up, I guess.
I'll get you a nice bitch, too. I know a whore that'll bang anything.
Yeah?
Whoa, she's stacked.
Anything.
Anything.
Is she stacked?
She needs to be stacked for Mike.
Well, you know.
Oh, you like
literally, a pile of bodies.
You like the heavyweights, huh?
Yeah, like, not really skinny chicks, but like someone with a little bonage.
Oh, bonage?
Okay. Bonage.
You want a girl who's going to lick your bag when it gets a little sweaty after dancing?
I want to get it nice and sweaty. Just have that skank fucking smell it. You know what I mean? And have it.
That's you know a girl skank. Like that?
Fuck.
Do you know a nice girl that'll smell a sweaty ball sack
after he dances?
We got a girl named AL. She'll definitely take care of you, though.
Yeah.
Ass liquor.
She pretty?
Oh, ass liquor.
Mike doesn't like his asshole liquor.
No, buddy, I'm afraid of it. I'm just like, that. My ass is my private property, really.
What? Man.
She's from Ethiopia. She'll eat that ass.
Oh,
Ethiopia.
Man. She'll eat anything. Right.
I like that when you said Ethiopia.
He did like that. Mike lit up. What's up with Ethiopia?
You love Ethiopian bitches.
His eyes got all big and shit.
Yeah.
This guy's a monkey.
Wow.
What's that about, Mike?
She likes the dick in her face because it swats the flies away. Ethiopia.
I just like the women that are unique and exotic.
You like exotic.
Yeah.
Exotic pussy, right?
Yeah. Would you fuck an Ethiopian girl?
Yeah. White women are boring. It's like that. I don't know. It's like
boring.
Well, now white women are boring. Get out of here.
Yeah. White women.
It depends on the woman. Though. I mean, like I said, I'm not the average white L.L. Bean pilgrim guy. Really,
you dance pretty well, though. I mean, you move good for a big guy.
Yeah, I try.
Jay-Z.
We didn't play
proud.
Any music though. We should have played music.
I mean, I did the niggas in Paris.
Now, we need a little bit of music, because I thought that was pretty good.
Yeah, we should have music, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was wiggling kind of weird. You saw the way he wiggled? It was crazy.
He wiggled a bit.
Some boxing moves. He was. He was fucking throwing punches.
Notice, growing up, me and my brothers had a lot of punching fights and drinking and carrying on. Oh, yeah.
Thank God we have this thing called the VIP section. We don't have to be in a crowd with the losers.
Oh, shit.
You
need
to be in your own shit.
Yeah, that's where the players hang out.
Ethiopian chick will be there to lick that ass.
You need your ass.
He's happy. Look at him. He's so happy, huh?
Oh, yeah. Just the prospect.
I know. It's like, I'm baby.
Damn.
I'm not going to pull the bones for a few days now.
Oh, it's what we got.
All right, Mike, you got to work this for a little while. You got to get up and dance.
Stand up.
He's ill, yo. Hey. I'm going to play his for him, too.
There is like a. All right. It's kind of.
Yeah, Jim, man. Some new shit right
now.
Oh,
the finger's going in the air.
Mike's nice.
Got any other moves?
White nigga could dance.
That's about it, really. That's the only move you got.
That's the only ones I got, guys. You twerk? I really don't have much.
You twerk?
We're sweating, too, yo.
A little twerking action.
Girls would dance with him in the club, right?
Yeah, of course.
Thank you.
Well, thank you. I think we got to go home. I think we're in Ron and Fez time.
Yeah, we are.
Thank you, Mike.
Thank you, Mike.
For real, I think we're in.
I'm sorry. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, that was great.
We haven't done this to the guys in a while. Sorry,
no,
Ron.
Man.
I got to piss.
Sorry to Ron and the gang.
Me and my day,
kid, thank you, brother.
Thank you. Always a pleasure, man.
Thank you, Jim.
Mike Buschetti, who, man... has
so
become
much.
A regular
oh,
on the spot.
Yes.
Follow Mike Buschetti on Twitter. I'm going to give that out again for you,
thank
Mikey.
You guys.
Where's your thing? There is. I don't know if I have your thing anymore. It's Mike B O C C
H E T T I.
Yeah. All right. Mike Buschetti on Twitter. B O C C H E T T I. All right. From the Artie Lang Show, man. Fucking funny, Mike. Thanks for coming in today.
So much fun.
All right. And Ron and Fez, I guess, are next, right?
Yes.
All right. See you tomorrow.
Channel on Sirius XM. Recently. Alright, well that sucked. To hear the Opie and Anthony Show 5 days a week live on satellite radio, online on your phone or tablet, or even on demand, go to SiriusXM.com. Also, interact with the Opie and Anthony Show on Twitter at Opie Radio, at Anthony Cumia, and at Jim Norton.